Just from this input image, this video has been generated under 60 seconds locally on my computer. So this is the power of Swarm UI and Conf UI backend with my installation, with my workflow, setup and optimizations. And it is just amazing. Amazing motion, amazing movement. It also completed the missing arm. So this is just perfect. Greetings everyone. Today I am going to introduce you how to generate videos inside Swarm UI with WAM 2.1 model, including both image to video and also text to video, because how to use this model inside Swarm UI is not very clear, hard to understand. Moreover, there is something huge, something new, which is improving the speed of the generation in WAM 2.1, significantly speeding up. It is called as Chaos with Laura, maybe you have heard it. It was a very popular post on Stable Diffusion subreddit and also famous on Sweet AI as well. This is bringing a massive speed up, and today we are also going to use it to massively speed up our generation speed. Moreover, I will show how to double the FPS of the output video with Rife on Swarm UI. Everything will be as usual. One click the install, download and use. All you need to do will be just type your prompt and enjoy the weave. So let's begin with the installation. If you already have previously installed, just go to here and download the latest zip file. If you didn't yet, please watch this tutorial and learn how to install. The link will be in the description of the video. So I will get this zip file into my Swarm UI installation, which is here. Paste it, then right click and WinRAR extract here, and I will overwrite all the previous files. Then double click the start download modules app.bat file, more info run anyway. This will update everything first, then it will start the Swarm UI downloader. Updating libraries may take like 1 minute or maybe more depending on your internet speed. Okay, everything updated and the downloader started. This is the latest version of downloader. Then I have implemented a WAM 2.1 GGUF bundle. You can download this and you can also manually download the modules from the video generation modules you see inside WAM 2.1. There are a lot of modules. So let's just download the bundle for now. This will also download the necessary LoRa file. The LoRa file is also available inside the LoRa section here, various LoRa modules, and you will see that WAM 2.1 Chaos with text to video, image to video LoRa model. Just wait for downloads to be completed. It will download everything automatically into Acure Swarm UI folder. If you want to use them inside Conf UI, just check this checkbox and give the models path of your Conf UI. For example, we are using the Conf UI from here. So I enter inside the Conf UI models, copy this path, paste it here. Check this box, then click the download button and it will download them into the accurate folders. So since I previously have downloaded some of the modules, they are all skipped. It will only download the new necessary files as we are seeing right now. And the download is fully optimized. It will use your entire internet speed. If you get errors, you can uncheck this, but before unchecking it, restart the application and it should work. Also, if you get download errors, it could be due to your VPN, antivirus, so disable them, change them and try again. So all the modules have been downloaded. We can see the queue size is zero. This is fully queue based system and everything has been downloaded. Now what we need to do is, first of all, I recommend to update your Swarm UI. You will see that we have Windows Update Swarm UI, so double click it, more info run anyway. It will update the Swarm UI to latest version, then click Windows Start Swarm UI.bat file, run anyway, and the Swarm UI has been started. First of all, I recommend you to enable display advanced options from here. Then what you should do is, in image to video, there is video frame interpolation method. So first of all, you need to install it. Once you installed it, you will see a button here to install, restart Swarm UI. If in the first restart, if it doesn't work, you can restart again and you will have the video frame interpolation method automatically enabled and working. Then what about the parameters, the settings? It is super important. I have prepared two presets. Let me delete them to show you. Okay, and okay. Then I will click import presets. There is upload JSON file. You can also overwrite existing presets. So choose file and amazing Swarm UI presets and import. and they are both imported. Don't worry, I will show every settings. So first, let's begin with image to video model, which is more preferred model. So we have our models here. There are a lot of GGUF versions, and each version has different quality and VRAM requirements. So depending on your GPU, you should use the accurate version. So I have RTX 5090 and I have RTX 3090 Ti. Therefore, I am going to use GGUF Q6, which is the default model. However, if you have a lower VRAM GPU, then you can download the lower GGUF version like GGUF Q4KM. This is the lowest GGUF. Unfortunately, with SwarmAI, I couldn't find yet. I will look for. There isn't block swapping, so it is fully loading into VRAM. Else, it is using shared VRAM, and if you use shared VRAM, it will be so slow. So first, let's pick the 1.2.1 image to video model GGUF. I have selected it. There is one very crucial thing. When you click edit metadata, you need to see that it is accurately metadata like this and standard resolution. Now this is super important. Depending on your GPU, I recommend to change this. 640 to 640 is really great, really working good, but natively this model is 960 to 960. And what does this change do? This change will impact all of the aspect ratios that you use. So you see, whatever the aspect ratio I choose here will use the base resolution the model has. Therefore, you can also download the 480p model. It is up to you, but I am using this model and I am using 640 to 640. It is working great. So we selected our model. This is our selected model. You can see 1.2.1 14 billion parameters, image to video 720p GGUF Q6K. This is a really, really high quality model. Then we will select our LoRa. You see 1.2.1 chaos with 14 billion parameters LoRa. The resolution here is not important. I had changed it, but it was like 906 to 906 by default. Okay, we have selected our models. Now, how do we set up the parameters, which is one of the most important thing? First of all, you will see that there is fast chaos with 1.2.1 image to video. So click here and direct apply, and it will apply all the settings for you. So let's verify them. Step count is 8, but you can also use step count 4. So either 8 or 4. CFG scale is 1. This is image to video model, so I uncheck this. This may be checked because of your other previous usages. Whichever the aspect ratio you prefer, it will depend on the image I will show. The sampling is UniPC. This is super important. You need to make init image selected, choose file, select the image you want to animate. So for example, let's choose this. Then click this res and use closest aspect ratio, and it will set the aspect ratio. You can also make this use exact aspect ratio, and it will use the exact aspect ratio like this. Then init image creativity has to be 0. This is super important, so pay attention to that. All other settings are like this. Then we will select the image to video model from here, whichever the model you are using. I am using GGUFQ. So number of frames, this is super important. This will determine your video duration, and if you make it longer, it will use more VRAM. Not only it will take longer to process, it will use more VRAM, and if you use entire GPU VRAM, it will be very slow. You will see on NVI tab. Let me demonstrate you again how to open NVI tab. Pip install NVI tab, type NVI tab, and here. So if you are seeing a very low watt usage here, that means that your GPU is using shared VRAM, therefore it will be super slow, and you want to avoid that. As a demonstration, let's make it 49 frames. Video CFG is 1 and video steps is 8. We are not using video to video creativity right now. Video output, I prefer H265, and frame interpolation, I'm going to use Rife, and I will make this 2, so it will become 16 FPS to 32 FPS. And advanced video options, this is also important. Video FPS is 16, video min CFG is 1. At the very bottom, there is other fixes, and we can set the first 4 frames to be trimmed. This is an error due to the 1. This is not mandatory, so it will trim 4 frames from the beginning if you are getting errors. This is recommended, so you can also make it 0. Okay, what else we need to set? We need to set a prompt for this. So let's select a prompt from our previous generation. For example, this is the prompt. Okay, the prompt is very simple. A red ant performing a weightlifting repetition, lifting the barbell up and then slowly lowering it, the hands, legs show effort. Our image is here and hit generate. By the way, I have dual GPU RTX 5090 and RTX 3090 Ti, and we can see that I have added them as the backend with the Sage attention, as I have shown in the previous video. So when I go to models and click load now, then I will click generate again and it will start generating on my second GPU as well. So let's just wait. If it doesn't work, I will show again. So it is going to load. Yes, it started. So we can compare their speed. As I said, pay attention to the watt usages here. It should be as much as close to your maximum watt. We can see that it fit into my VRAM of my GPU. It is using 19.5 gigabytes of VRAM. So it is using my entire GPU power. It is not using any shared VRAM or anything. Therefore, both of them is at their maximum speed. And when we go to the logs, we can see the speed of the each GPU. So the RTX 5090 was 5.74 second IT. So it took total, like, let's see, 70 seconds to generate this video. Okay, this is the video. This didn't turn out to be very animated, so we need to try again with another seed or perhaps change the prompt. Let's see the RTX 3090 Ti speed. So the RTX 3090 Ti is like 11 seconds per IT because it is fitting into my VRAM. This is very crucial and important. So the RTX 3090 Ti will take like 1.5 minutes. There isn't too much difference because both of them are fitting into VRAM. However, if it was not fitting into my VRAM, then the things would be very, very different. And that 8 gigabytes of extra VRAM that RTX 5090 has is very, very crucial. So this is the logic. We upload our image, we type our prompt, we set our settings. And if you want a longer videos, longer duration of generation, then you need to use video frames. Okay, this one has more motion. By the way, you see that it has a cropped leg because it is in the original image. I mean, it is not the model mistake. We can see that this is the original image that I am using. So the leg is also missing here. And this is the animated image. I am also working on a very, very amazing upscaler, video upscaler. So you will be able to generate videos in lower resolution and upscale later. It is diffusion based, like the newest model of Topaz AI, but it will be better than Topaz AI. You will see it. So our videos are getting generated. So where they are saved? They are saved inside the Swarm UI, inside output, inside local raw, and they will be inside here, the date of my generations. So you can directly share them. They are saved as MP4 files and you can play them like this. And you can see that it is completing that missing leg at a part of the video. Yes, I can see here. Yes, you see, the model is just completing it itself. Wow, this turned out to be really, really great. You see the motion? This is a full motion. Just from this input image, this video has been generated under 60 seconds locally on my computer. So this is the power of Swarm UI and Conf UI backend with my installation, with my workflow setup and optimizations. And it is just amazing. Amazing motion, amazing movement. It also completed the missing arm. So this is just perfect. Okay, so let's move to text to video generation. For text to video generation, we are going to use 1.2.1 text to video. By the way, you can set different images to every one of these models if you are getting confused. For example, upload the image here. Click here, edit metadata, and say use image and save, and it will use that image. So you won't get confused with that. So where is text to video model here? 1.2.1 text to video GGUF. So I will select it and I will say load now. And I will go to presets and I will say text to video apply, direct apply. Now it will apply all the text to video presets. In the text to video, we are not using init image. This is important. What are the other changes? Images 1, seat minus 1. Okay, CFG is 1, steps is 8. Text to video is selected. Text to video FPS 16. Number of frames 49. You see frame interpolation right is also available here. So I am making it 2 so that it will increase double the FPS. And the resolution, as I said, you can set the resolution of the base model to something different from 960 to like 640 or 768. So depending on your GPU and the time you want to wait, then I can select any custom aspect ratio and it will set the resolution accordingly. By the way, switch model so it will update it. Okay, let's generate 9 to 16. This is the resolution. Let's copy one of the prompt from the older. Okay, this is the prompt. Let's copy paste it here. Now, what other changes we have? I'm using sampling as uni PC. Scheduler is default. No init image. There is no image to video. So uncheck this. Advanced video, video FPS 16 and video CFG is 1. So these are all the settings. I am also using other fixes. Stream video start 4 frames. Then all I need to do is generate. By the way, don't forget to select LoRa as well. Because with this LoRa, we are able to get this quality only in 8 steps. And furthermore, to speed up, you can install T-Cache. However, we are already doing 8 steps, so T-Cache probably would break it. And if you want a higher quality, you can always remove the Sage Attention, which is speeding up the generation, and get even a better quality. So let's see the speed of the text to video generation on both of the GPUs. Pay attention that both of them should fit into VRAM, otherwise that wouldn't be a fair comparison. Okay, so with 49 frames and with this resolution, which is the, let me show you one more time, 576 to 1008, it is using 19.8 gigabytes of VRAM. Let's see the speed in the logs debug. Okay, so the speed of RTX 5090 is 8.40 seconds per IT. Let's see the speed of the 3090 Ti. The Comfy i0 is my 5090 and the Comfy i1 is my 3090 Ti. Yes, so it is 8.46 seconds to 18.24 seconds. However, I am recording a video and it is also using a lot of GPU power as well. Therefore, this is not a very fair comparison, but you are seeing the speed difference. It is more than twice. Alright, the first video has been generated and it is looking really, really great. By the way, I used this prompt from Sweet AI and this is the output. And hopefully when my diffusion-based upscaler arrives, it will be way better. Let me also show you a quick peek of it. It will be inside Ultimate Video. So let's click try star.bat file. I am adding so many features to this video upscaler application. It will be able to automatically split video into the clips so that you will be able to caption prompt each part separately and upscale each part separately so that the changed motions will have accurate descriptions. So this will be the basic interface. I am still improving it and adding new features. It will be able to automatically caption each video with Coq VLM2 video model. Then it will support ratio upscale, downscale, then upscale. A lot of features. It will support max frame per batch. So with using a more powerful GPU, you will be able to get 10 times, more than 10 times better quality than the paid premium Topaz AI model. It will have all kind of optimizations, FFmpeg presets. So if you have, you know, any ideas, you can message me about this. This is not done yet. It is still in development and it is taking huge time. But hopefully this will be amazing. The very best video upscaler. I hope that you have enjoyed today's video. So we can see that two videos have been generated on each GPU. The quality is magnificent. The time it takes is magnificent. So the RTX 3090 Ti took 170 seconds. RTX 5090 took 90 seconds under 2 minutes. Only if you increase the resolution and if you increase the frame count, it will use more VRAM and it will take more time. So it is up to you to decide which resolution and which frame. Hopefully see you later.